Okay, so I had a real quick question. What is a burnout? So autistic burnout. Oh man, okay. Before I knew I was autistic, I thought I was losing my mind a few years. Everything that could possibly happen and go wrong and be the most incredible stress you could possibly think of had been happening in my life. I was in my mid-30s. I had two babies. I had a husband who was overseas on active military duty on the front lines in the military, in the army, during a war. And if it was a stress, I had it. Money, everything, you name it, it was happening. Health, babies who weren't doing well, all kinds of stuff. And I thought I was losing my mind. I thought I was going crazy. I was stuck. I knew I had things I needed to do and I could not make myself. It didn't matter what. I had no energy. I had brain fog. My emotions were all over the place. I felt completely wiped out. I felt completely out of control of everything. And I thought I was just losing my mind and I was terrified. And I was so scared. I was scared to even tell anyone because I thought this, no one's going to believe me first that this is happening. And I can't afford to go completely nuts and put myself in the hospital. I have two babies that need me and I'm the only parent in the United States. So I just kept going and I didn't realize that I had hit autistic burnout. Autistic burnout happens for us as autistics in a very different way. You know, you hear the term burnout in the neurotypical world, and that's usually when people have been consistently pushing themselves and they hit a block and they're just exhausted. You know, they're tired. They've got to recharge their batteries. That's a neurotypical burnout. An autistic burnout is deeper and it's different in this way. Autistic burnout for us, it is an accumulation of stress over a long period of time where we are not able to self-care, recharge, and allow ourselves to have that space that we need. We have a lot of sensory sensitivities, and that comes in a lot of different forms. And when we don't have that space to process, to rest in restoration time, then we get into this chronic cycle of stress, overwhelm, and exhaustion. For autistics, when this happens, we experience a loss of skills that can be temporary or, and which really is scary, a loss of skills that can be permanent or that the skills are lost and they do not come back to the same level that you had before you hit a burnout. In some situations with autistic burnout, it can take weeks, it can take months. And sadly, sometimes, like in my first autistic burnout, it took years to recover because I had no idea that's what it was. When that does happen, I do have a worksheet in place in the group under burnout and meltdown, because meltdowns are a quick temporary response to a stressor or an overwhelmed situation that is short term. A burnout is an extended period of stress. And one of the things as we get older that some of the research is looking into is how do we regain the skills that we've lost during those burnouts? Because I have selective mutism and I will go completely mute. I can't talk. I might want to. I'm thinking it. I can type it. You know, I can say a few words to maybe one key person I can talk to, but I can't really talk to anybody else. And everyone experiences autistic burnout in a different or unique way for them. There are similar things that do happen. Recovery from that, the biggest thing is to be aware of what caused the burnout, what those stressors were, where you didn't have self-care in place. And that's why that's one of the things I bring up in this step two question. But being able to know what things help restore you, what actions, what rest, that's really important. So if you guys need to take, you know, time after this and go get that worksheet, I put that worksheet together for myself And it's one that I use. It's one that I have been sharing with hundreds of other autistics, and they have been using it to create their own plan for meltdowns and burnouts that really it's tailored for you and it helps tremendously. So I suggest you go out and get that, because you got to do that type of thing. It's hard to do it in the middle of a burnout, but it really just to start going through the process of asking yourself some of the questions in that burnout worksheet will help you tremendously get through what you're going through in the process and get to the other side. Did that answer your question?
So basically something you pretty much can't get over. It goes a long period of time. Is that correct?
It is an extended period of stress and overwhelm without any recovery, and you hit a point where you start to lose your skills and abilities to function. And then it will take weeks, months, or years to recover from sometimes. Yeah.